Zoom, zoom, zoom. So about top surgery, how could you be sure? I wanted to answer this. I think it's a question I also had like over the years. I think even in the end, like I knew I wanted it, but still it is kind of normal to have doubts. There's room for doubts. It's normal to question yourself. And also when you, if you really have the date for your top surgery and it's coming, you start questioning it and you start getting a little bit scared, if you're like me, because I get scared like easily. I get anxious easily when something happens that I'm not prepared for, and that's just life. Things happen that you're not prepared for. Top surgery you can prepare a little bit for, like mentally, but not completely. You have never done this before, so it will always be something big and something scary. Even if you watch like a million videos online like I did of other people, your experience will be your experience and it can be way different than somebody else's. Also depending on which hospital you go to, which surgeon you go to, how much money you have to pay, in which country you are, how many friends you have, like real friends and family, and you know, there's many things to consider, and you cannot be like 100% prepared for it even if you try to. For me, the first few days were really different than I thought it would be. I imagined I would be in a lot of pain, and that was true, but I didn't know like mentally how it would impact me. I had a whole different vision of that in my mind. I thought I would be maybe a little sad, but I didn't think I would think I made a mistake or something. I just thought, okay, I'm going to be a little sad because I had to do this, but I never knew that I would be thinking, why did I do this? Was this a mistake? And like completely scaring myself with all these thoughts, you know? What I can say though is that I did make sure that it was not an impulsive decision. I had been thinking about the possibility of getting top surgery for quite a few years. I think it was 5 years ago that I started to think about wanting to change something there. I wasn't thinking about top surgery as much because that seemed too scary and I didn't want to think about that possibility. But I did look up breast reduction. So I think that was the first step for me to get to top surgery. And then about 2 years ago, I saw people who got top surgery. I started to know more about trans and non-binary people, and it didn't seem that strange to me anymore because I saw representation. Still, I was scared about telling other people how I felt about this and what they would say if I really wanted to do this. Only a year ago, I told my parents that I probably would do this, but even then I said probably. I was scared to say that I was 100% sure because I was still having a few doubts. Sometimes I said to people I was 100% sure, then I said I was 90% sure. It's a whole process. But what I did do before surgery, I wrote myself a letter explaining why I needed this to prepare myself for like doubts afterwards if they would come. The letter didn't help that much, I have to say, but it was good for me in advance to just write it and remind myself of all the reasons why I needed this. I know that I wrote something about my youth, about remembering being like a child. Back then, I know I like the freedom of not having to wear something here when I did not have breasts yet. So I always wore like something here, of course, at the bottom, but I didn't wear a top here when I didn't have to. So I do have some pictures from when I was a child, like in front of a waterfall with my sister and just like being topless. And I remember that feeling really great. And I also remember the first time that I had to wear a real bra, because I know that I, even though I didn't know I was trans or non-binary, I remember that I tried as long as I could to wear more stuff that was just a small fabric so it wouldn't show my breasts too much, until some lady in a shop told me that I needed to wear a real bra, like my breasts were getting too big and otherwise my back would hurt and stuff. So I remember feeling a little bit defeated, but I also quickly made the shift in my head that I needed to start wearing real bras now, and kind of put it in the back of my mind that I did not really like wearing that, even up until a point that I think I kind of loved wearing a bra. But I also think I just made myself believe that I wanted to appear like I was still more feminine than I actually felt, you know? And you kind of do what you have to do to love yourself. So you try to love that part of your body, of course. You do everything you can to love everything about yourself. That's self-love. Even if there's some part of yourself that you don't like that much, you try to embrace it before you do anything like drastic, you know? Like what I just did, like top surgery is very drastic. Let's not pretend that it isn't.